Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll be reviewing how to calculate elasticity of demand given nothing but the demand equation and a change in price. With that said, let's get into it. So as promised, in this video, we'll be calculating the elasticity of demand. And to do that, we need to remember the formula for elasticity of demand. And that's simply the change in Q, or the change in quantity divided by quantity, over the change in price divided by price. And for this formula to work, you need two different prices and two different quantities. So we're looking for a P1, P2, Q1, and a Q2. That's just the old price, the new price, the old quantity, and the new quantity. These are the key values that we need to find in order to calculate the elasticity of demand. Well, luckily for us, the new P and the old P are already given to us, and they're simply $10 and $20, and we know what they are because they're given to us in the question. However, we need to calculate for the old quantity and the new quantity, and to do that, we're simply going to sub in the old and new prices, so P1 and P2, into the demand equation one at a time, and that's going to yield us Q1 and Q2 respectively. So let's start with Q1. We're going to sub it into the demand equation. That's going to give us Q1 is equal to 200 minus 5 times 10. Again, 10 is just P1. Simplifying this further, we get Q1 is equal to 200 minus 50. And then finally, we can derive that Q1 must be equal to 150. We'll do the same thing for Q2. Q2 is equal to 200 minus 5 times 20. 20 is just P2. Simplifying further, we get Q2 is equal to 200 minus 100. And then finally, we can derive that Q2 must be equal to 100. So now I have my P1, my P2, my Q1, and my Q2. Now that we have these four necessary values, we can finally solve for elasticity of demand. Now, you might be looking at the elasticity formula saying that looks like percentage change, and it is. Now, if you want a detailed video on how to calculate all four types of elasticity, we have a video for each type on our channel, so feel free to check those out. We'll link them in the description. To calculate percentage change, I'll explain it like I have in other videos. It's new minus old over old. That's the same as the change in Q divided by Q, or the change in P divided by P. Let me illustrate what that looks like with the numbers we have in front of us. So elasticity of demand is equal to the new quantity, which is 100, minus the old Q, which is 150, divided by the old Q, which is 150. And I do the same thing for price. New price minus old price over old price. So 20 is the new price minus 10 divided by 10. That's the easiest way for you to remember percentage change. Simplifying this further, I get negative 50 over 150 divided by 10 over 10. And then of course, that's going to be negative 0.33 over 1, which if I take the absolute value as I want to calculate the magnitude of elasticity is 0.33. And you might be wondering to yourself, well, isn't the elasticity negative? And it is, but when you want to calculate if something is elastic or inelastic, you have to consider the absolute value because we know that the price elasticity of demand for a normal good will always be negative. It has to be because the relationship between P and QD is always negative. That follows the law of demand, where if you increase the price, then quantity demanded will go down. And that's exactly what you see here. Price goes up from $10 to $20, and quantity demanded goes down from $150 to $100. So because those act in opposite directions, elasticity of demand for a normal good will always be negative. Anyways, assuming that you have that knowledge, we take the absolute value, which is 0.33. That is obviously less than 1. And since it's less than 1, we can deduce that demand must be inelastic. And that's all there is to it. I hope that you were able to follow along with this video and it really shed some light on how to calculate the elasticity of demand. Once again, we have videos on all four types of elasticity, so feel free to check those out if you need additional practice. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and let us know in the comment section what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.